Hey everybody, I'm Geno Reynolds from The Real Opinion. Today on The Real Opinion, we're going to be talking about two sequels. One is about a male entertainer trying to get back his past glory. The other is the next chapter, rewriting history in the Terminator franchise. Here are a couple of quick reviews for two films that you may want to consider or not consider checking out. First up is Magic Mike XXL. Set 3 years after the first film, Mike decides he wants to return to the stage because his relationship hasn't worked out, because it was so believable from the first movie. Plot-wise, this movie's story didn't have any real conflict. They do address things like why Matthew McConaughey's character isn't in the film. The story is way more lighthearted and at times kind of funny. The new love story for Mike works a little better. Amber Heard is way more believable as a love interest, but that's not saying much. Cody Horn, who played Brooke in the first film, had the charisma of a cardboard cutout, but story isn't why this movie's audience comes to see this, now is it? Look, I'm not exactly the target audience for this movie, so it didn't really do anything for me, but by the climax of the film, I'm sure the target audience will be satisfied and glad they came. For the target audience, it's not bro time, it's show time. Next up is Terminator Genisys. Want to destroy mankind? There's an app for that. At least that's the idea behind this sequel. Like the Star Trek movies have done, this film tries to rewrite the series' history by changing the past, in a movie franchise already about changing the past. I think that if it would have kept it simple, it might have worked a little better, but the movie borrows from the TV show and has our heroes jump forward in time to try to stop the new incarnation of Skynet. When it comes to keeping time and continuity straight, this movie just kind of brushes it aside and chalks it up to a time paradox. The chemistry of the love story between Jai Courtney and Emilia Clarke feels a bit forced, not natural like it did in the first film. Old Arnie is decent in his return to the role as protector. They finally do something to his character that I've always wanted to see, but to tell you would kind of spoil it. That being said, anytime the characters needed answers about something, he became a literal deus ex machina. To me, this is just an okay sequel. I do feel that even if the trailers hadn't spoiled all the surprises, and they did, this film still would have been a bit of a mess. Like Jurassic World, if you're going to return to a beloved franchise, give us something new, not just a film with a new paint job. But remember, it's only just one guy's opinion. I'm Geno Reynolds from The Real Opinion. Until next time.